In mathematics, a Gaussian function is a function of the form. For arbitrary real constants A, B, C, D, the graph of a Gaussian is a characteristic symmetric bell curve shape that quickly falls off towards D. The parameter A is the height of the curve's peak, B is the position of the center of the peak, C controls the width of the bell, and D is the value that the function asymptotically approaches far from the peak. Gaussian functions are widely used in statistics where they describe the normal distributions, in signal processing where they serve to define Gaussian filters, in image processing where two-dimensional Gaussians are used for Gaussian blurs, and in mathematics where they are used to solve heat equations and diffusion equations and to define the Weier stress transform. Properties: Gaussian functions arise by applying the exponential function to a general quadratic function. The Gaussian functions are thus those functions whose logarithm is a quadratic function. The parameter C is related to the full width at half maximum of the peak according to. Alternatively, the parameter C can be interpreted by saying that the two inflection points of the function occur at xi equals a bar AAC and xi equals a bar plus AC. The full width at tenth of maximum for a Gaussian could be of interest and is. Gaussian functions are analytic, and their limit as AAAIs are zero. Gaussian functions are among those functions that are elementary but lack elementary antiderivatives. The integral of the Gaussian function is the error function. Nonetheless, their improper integrals over the whole real line can be evaluated exactly, using the Gaussian integral. And one obtains. This integral is 1 if and only if or equals a1 slash, cosh, 2i euro, and in this case the Gaussian is the probability density function of a normally distributed random variable with expected value i1 quarter a equals ab invariance i2 florins a equals ac2. These Gaussians are plotted in the accompanying figure. Gaussian functions centered at zero minimize the Fourier uncertainty principle. The product of two Gaussian functions is a Gaussian, and the convolution of two Gaussian functions is also a Gaussian, with STD deviation being the quadratic mean of the original STD deviations. Taking the Fourier transform of a Gaussian function with parameters all equals a1, bar equals a0 and c yields another Gaussian function, with parameters, bar equals a0 and. So in particular the Gaussian functions with bar equals a0 and chi equals a are kept fixed by the Fourier transform. The fact that the Gaussian function is an eigenfunction of the continuous Fourier transform allows us to derive the following interesting identity from the Poisson summation formula. Integral of a Gaussian function, the integral of an arbitrary Gaussian function is. An alternative form is. Where f must be strictly positive for the integral to converge. Proof: the integral for some real constants a, b, c greater than 0 can be calculated by putting it into the form of a Gaussian integral. First, the constant a can simply be factored out of the integral. Next, the variable of integration is changed from x to y equals a zap plus ab. And then to. Then, using the Gaussian integral identity, we have two-dimensional Gaussian function. In two dimensions, the power to which E is raised in the Gaussian function is any negative definite quadratic form. Consequently, the level sets of the Gaussian will always be ellipses. A particular example of a two-dimensional Gaussian function is. Here the coefficient A is the amplitude, xo, yo is the center and I florin y are the x and y spreads of the blob. The figure on the right was created using a equals 1, xo equals 0, yo equals 0, I florin x equals I florin y equals 1. The volume under the Gaussian function is given by. In general, a two-dimensional elliptical Gaussian function is expressed as. Where the matrix is positive definite. Using this formulation, the figure on the right can be created using a equals 1, equals, A equals C equals 1 half, B equals 0. Meaning of parameters for the general equation, for the general form of the equation the coefficient A is the height of the peak and is the center of the blob. If we set. Then we rotate the blob by a clockwise angle. This can be seen in the following examples, using the following octave code one can easily see the effect of changing the parameters. Such functions are often used in image processing and in computational models of visual system function. See the articles on scale space and affine shape adaptation. Also see multivariate normal distribution. Multidimensional Gaussian function. In a dimensional space, a Gaussian function can be defined as: where is a column of coordinates, is a positive definite matrix, and denotes transposition. The integral of this Gaussian function over the whole dimensional space is given as: it can be easily calculated by diagonalizing the matrix and changing the integration variables to the eigenvectors of. More generally, a shifted Gaussian function is defined as: where is the shift vector and the matrix can be assumed to be symmetric and positive definite. The following integrals with this function can be calculated with the same technique: Gaussian profile estimation, a number of fields such as stellar photometry, Gaussian beam characterization, and emission absorption line spectroscopy work with sampled Gaussian functions and need to accurately estimate the height, position, and width parameters of the function. These are: and for a 1D Gaussian function, and for a 2D Gaussian function. The most common method for estimating the profile parameters is to take the logarithm of the data and fit a parabola to the resulting data set. While this provides a simple least squares fitting procedure, the resulting algorithm is biased by excessively weighting small data values, and this can produce large errors in the profile estimate. One can partially compensate for this through weighted least squares estimation, in which the small data values are given small weights, but this too can be biased by allowing the tail of the Gaussian to dominate the fit. In order to remove the bias, one can instead use an iterative procedure in which the weights are updated at each iteration. Once one has an algorithm for estimating the Gaussian function parameters, it is also important to know how accurate those estimates are. While an estimation algorithm can provide numerical estimates for the variance of each parameter, one can use Cramer copyright Ra-Euro-Ra bound theory to obtain an analytical expression for the lower bound on the parameter variances, given some assumptions about the data. The noise in the measured profile is either IID Gaussian, or the noise is Poisson distributed. The spacing between each sampling is uniform. The peak is well sampled, so that less than 10% of the area or volume under the peak lies outside the measurement region. The width of the peak is much larger than the distance between sample locations. When these assumptions are satisfied, the following covariance matrix K applies for the 1D profile parameters, and under IID Gaussian noise and under Poisson noise. Where is the width of the pixels used to sample the function, is the quantum efficiency of the detector, and indicates the standard deviation of the measurement noise. Thus, the individual variances for the parameters are, in the Gaussian noise case, and in the Poisson noise case. For the 2D profile parameters giving the amplitude, position, and width of the profile, the following covariance matrices apply. Where the individual parameter variances are given by the diagonal elements of the covariance matrix. Discrete Gaussian. One may ask for a discrete analog to the Gaussian. This is necessary in discrete applications, particularly digital signal processing. A simple answer is to sample the continuous Gaussian, yielding the sampled Gaussian kernel. However, this discrete function does not have the discrete analogs of the properties of the continuous function, and can lead to undesired effects, as described in the article Scale Space Implementation. An alternative approach is to use discrete Gaussian kernel, where denotes the modified Bessel functions of integer order. This is the discrete analog of the continuous Gaussian in that it is the solution to the discrete diffusion equation, just as the continuous Gaussian is the solution to the continuous diffusion equation. Applications: Gaussian functions appear in many contexts in the natural sciences, the social sciences, mathematics, and engineering. Some examples include: in statistics and probability theory, Gaussian functions appear as the density function of the normal distribution, which is a limiting probability distribution of complicated sums, according to the central limit theorem. Gaussian functions are the Green's function for the diffusion equation, a partial differential equation that describes the time evolution of a mass density under diffusion. Specifically, If the mass density at time t equals 0 is given by a Dirac delta, which essentially means that the mass is initially concentrated in a single point, then the mass distribution at time t will be given by a Gaussian function, with the parameter a being linearly related to 1 per rsht and c being linearly related to sht. More generally, if the initial mass density is I, x, then the mass density at later times is obtained by taking the convolution of I with a Gaussian function. The convolution of a function with a Gaussian is also known as a Weierstrass transform. A Gaussian function is the wave function of the ground state of the quantum harmonic oscillator. The molecular orbitals used in computational chemistry can be linear combinations of Gaussian functions called Gaussian orbitals. Mathematically, the derivatives of the Gaussian function can be represented using Hermite functions. The nth derivative of the Gaussian is the Gaussian function itself multiplied by the nth Hermite polynomial, up to scale. Consequently, Gaussian functions are also associated with the vacuum state in quantum field theory. Gaussian beams are used in optical and microwave systems. In scale space representation, Gaussian functions are used as smoothing kernels for generating multi-scale representations in computer vision and image processing. Specifically, derivatives of Gaussians are used as a basis for defining a large number of types of visual operations. Gaussian functions are used to define some types of artificial neural networks. In fluorescence microscopy, a 2D Gaussian function is used to approximate the area disk, describing the intensity distribution produced by a point source. In signal processing, they serve to define Gaussian filters, such as in image processing where 2D Gaussians are used for Gaussian blurs. In digital signal processing, one uses a discrete Gaussian kernel, which may be defined by sampling a Gaussian, or in a different way. In geostatistics, they have been used for understanding the variability between the patterns of a complex training image. They are used with kernel methods to cluster the patterns in the feature space. See also, normal distribution, Lorentzian function, integral of a Gaussian function, references. External links, MathWorld, includes a proof of the relations between C and FWHM, JavaScript to create Gaussian convolution kernels, integrating the bell curve at mathpages.com. Haskell, Elang and Perl implementation of Gaussian distribution, Benzim Hahn-Michael, n-dimensional cumulative function, and other useful facts about Gaussians and normal densities.